Welcome dear student, today we are going to see how to prepare aluminium hydroxide gel IP. This aluminium hydroxide gel is used as an antacid. Aim to prepare and submit aluminium hydroxide gel 50 ml. Requirements: chemicals, ammonium alum, then hydrated sodium carbonate, then peppermint oil and sodium benzoate and purified water. Then apparatus required to perform this practical: glass rod, electronic weighing balance, then beakers, measuring cylinder and pipette. Aluminium hydroxide gel is a suspension. So suspension are heterogeneous biphasic liquid in which insoluble solid particulates are uniformly distributed in a liquid phase, which may be stabilized by inclusion of suspending agents. Ideal qualities of suspension: it should settle slowly and redisperse easily. It should pour readily and evenly from its container. Then suspended particles should not form a cake. Suspended particles should be small and uniform sized. Then viscosity must not be so high. It should be chemically inert. Then formulation of suspension. So formulation of suspension includes different ingredients. First is wetting agents. They are added to disperse solid in a continuous liquid phase. Then flocculating agents are added to form a flock of drug particles. Then thickeners are added to increase viscosity of suspension. Then buffers and pH adjusting agents are added to stabilize the suspension to desired pH range. Then osmotic agents are used to adjust osmotic pressure comparable to the biological fluid. Then coloring agents are added to impart desired color to suspension and improve its elegance. Then preservatives are added to prevent microbial growth. External liquid vehicle are used into the formulation of suspension to construct structure of final suspension. Now we'll see what are the antacids. They are drugs which are usually alkaline substance and are used to neutralize the excess acid in the stomach of patient suffering from hyperacidity. Production of gastric HCl is a continuous process. It means use of antacid is also continuous process. Strong alkaline bases which will damage mucosal layer. The action of antacid should be a gradual without evoking rebound acidity. Also antacid should not have any side effects. Antacid give symptomatic relief from pain by neutralizing excess of hydrochloric acid, so they find use in a treatment of ulcer by reducing pain. Antacids are classified into different subclasses, that is systemic antacids. They are soluble and readily absorbable and capable of producing systemic electrolytic alteration and alkalosis. For example, sodium bicarbonate. Then second class of antacids, that is non-systemic antacids. These are not absorbed to a significant extent to do not alter an appreciable system. effect. This group is further divided into following subclasses. First subclass, that is aluminium containing antacid like aluminium hydroxide, aluminium phosphate, then basic aluminium carbonate, dihydroxyaluminium amino acetate. Then second class of non-systemic antacid, that is calcium containing antacids, calcium carbonate, tribasic calcium phosphate, then magnesium containing antacids, magnesium carbonate, magnesium hydroxide, then magnesium citrate, magnesium oxide, magnesium peroxide, magnesium trisilicate and phosphate. Then combination antacid preparation, aluminium hydroxide gel and magnesium hydroxide, aluminium hydroxide gel and magnesium trisilicate, then semithecon containing antacid, calcium carbonate containing antacids. In ideal requirement of antacid, it should be insoluble in water and has fine particle form. It should not be absorbable and cause systemic alkalosis. It should be able to exert its effect gradually over a long period of time. It should not be laxative or cause constipation. It should not cause any side effect. It should be stable and readily available. The reaction between antacid and gastric acid should not produce large volume of gas. The antacid should buffer in pH range 4 to 6. Antacid should probably inhibit pepsin and proteolytic enzymes. Now we'll see what is aluminium hydroxide and how it is used as an antacid. Molecular formula: AlOH3, relative molecular mass 78 gram per mole. Then chemical name aluminium hydroxide, then CAS number 216455-51. Then it is a white fine amorphous powder and odorless, practically insoluble in water, ethanol, and soluble into the hydrochloric acid and sodium hydroxide. Category: antacid, and storage condition: it should be kept in a tightly closed container. Aluminium hydroxide gel, it is an aqueous white viscous suspension of hydrated aluminium oxide having varying amount of basic aluminium carbonate. Mechanism: aluminium hydroxide gel is non-absorbable and exert very little systemic effect. If gel is formed by precipitation in a carbonate or bicarbonate reaction mixture, there may be some evolution of carbon dioxide when carbonate or bicarbonate anion react with gastric acid, but this reaction is very slow, so patient will not feel discomfort. Other drugs should not be taken with antacid simultaneously as there is a loss of antacid property. End product of neutralization of aluminium hydroxide gel with hydrochloric acid is aluminium chloride, which is water soluble astringent salt. This may cause constipation, nausea and vomiting. Then principle behind this experiment, aluminium hydroxide gel is an antacid suspension which is known as aluminium hydroxide suspension or aluminium hydroxide mixture. It is prepared by adding solution of potash alum slowly with a constant stirring to the solution of sodium carbonate, and after complete removal of carbon dioxide, a precipitated aluminium hydroxide is filtered. Then it is washed properly with water until it gets free from sulfate ion, and precipitate is suspended into the distilled water to required strength. So sodium carbonate react with the alum and will get aluminium hydroxide. Then formula of aluminium hydroxide gel: ammonium alum 40 gram, hydrated sodium carbonate 50 gram, then peppermint oil 0.1 ml, then sodium benzoate 0.1 gram, and purified water quantity sufficient to prepare 100 ml. So this is the formula for 100 ml of aluminium hydroxide gel. Now we are going to prepare 20 ml. So accordingly we require to calculate all quantities of all ingredients for the 20 ml. So for us, say for example, ammonium alum is required 40 gram for the 100 ml aluminium hydroxide gel. Then for the 20 ml it requires x gram. So by doing calculation, you can calculate how much aluminium alum is required for the 20 ml. Now it is 8 gram. So for the 20 ml you require to take 8 gram. Simply by doing cross multiplication, you can calculate how much quantity of a particular ingredient is required for the 20 ml of your formulation, because we have a quantities for the 100 ml with us. Similarly, here I have calculated hydrated sodium carbonate for 20 gram, then it is 10 gram. Sorry, 20 ml. Of aluminium hydroxide gel, and calculated value of hydrated sodium carbonate is 10 gram. Then peppermint oil 0.02 ml. Then sodium benzoate 0.02 gram. Then you require to prepare a table along with the ingredients, quantity given, quantity taken, and a role of each and every ingredient in that formulation. So first is ammonium alum, calculated value is 8 gram and it is used as the antacid. Then hydrated sodium carbonate, quantity taken 10 gram, used as an antacid. Then sodium benzoate, used as a preservative. Peppermint oil, used as a flavoring agent. Then purified water, used as a vehicle. Then we'll see actual procedure. Dissolve 8 gram of sodium carbonate dissolve 8 gram of ammonium alum into 40 ml of hot water. Then dissolve 10 gram of sodium carbonate in 50 ml of hot water. And add the above solution with constant stirring. Then add 30 ml hot water and then dilute it up to the 100 ml with cold water. Then there is a precipitation. Then you have to collect that PPT by filtration process, and then wash that precipitate and suspend it into the 20 ml purified water, which is containing peppermint oil and sodium benzoate. Then homogenize the resulting gel. Now we'll see actual demonstration of practical.
concentration of preparation of aluminium hydroxide gel IP 20 ml. So our working formula is ammonium alum 8 gram, then hydrated sodium carbonate 10 gram, sodium benzoate 0.02 gram, then peppermint oil 0.02 ml, and purified water up to 20 ml. Now we'll see actual demonstration of preparation of aluminium hydroxide gel IP 20 ml. So our working formula is ammonium alum 8 gram, then hydrated sodium carbonate 10 gram, sodium benzoate 0.02 gram, then peppermint oil 0.02 ml, and purified water up to 20 ml.
Now we'll see how to prepare label. So these type of the label you require to prepare, you have to mention name of your formulation, and then quantity aluminium hydroxide gel 20 ml. Then you have to mention how much amount of ingredient you have taken to prepare this 20 ml of aluminium hydroxide gel. Then mention manufacturing date, expiry date, then manufacturing LIC number and batch number. Then mention storage conditions. Then mention storage conditions, then category, as it is used as an antacid. So here I have mentioned category antacid. Then as we all know, it is a suspension. That's why strictly you have to mention check well before use. And at last, you have to mention name of manufacturing company or manufacturer. Then after sticking this label on container, our formulation is ready to use. Okay, we have filled our formulation in this bottle and labeled it with our prepared label. Then result, the aluminium hydroxide gel 20 ml was prepared and submitted. Now we'll see questions that will be asked in Viva and synopsis. What is use of aluminium hydroxide gel? Aluminium hydroxide gel is used as an antacid in the management of peptic ulcer, gastritis and gastric hyperacidity. What is the type of this dosage form? It is a suspension dosage form where this aluminium hydroxide is insoluble and hence it is dispersed into the water and turns into the suspension. What is the use of sodium benzoate in the formulation of aluminium hydroxide gel? So it is used as a preservative to avoid microbial growth into the formulation. Why peppermint water is used? It gives flavor to the mixture. Then enlist ingredients used in the formulation of suspension: wetting agents, flocculating agents, then thickeners, buffers and pH adjusting agents, then osmotic agents, then coloring agents and preservative. Then external liquid vehicles are used. Next question, what is the principle behind formulation of aluminium hydroxide gel mixture? It is prepared by adding solution of potash slowly with constant stirring to the solution of sodium carbonate, and after complete removal of carbon dioxide, precipitated aluminium hydroxide is filtered and washed properly with water until it gets free from sulfate ion, and the precipitate is suspended into the distilled water to the required strength. So this is a reaction of formulation of aluminium hydroxide gel by using sodium carbonate and alum. So this is all about aluminium hydroxide gel. Thank you.